Hello, it does look like you are first. After the Alabama, you should buy the G2 glass carrier. That's the ship you'll use for a while until you get the NCAT. And then after the NCAT, you should go for ACE. This server is a private server for if you own a Beluga Ace or Carpathia. So unless you own one of those, you can't join, unfortunately. Yeah, the join is the same as the last stream from the Beluga Ace Association Discord server. The G2 is 3 million credits. And to join the Beluga Ace server, if you're in the Bad Yacht Discord server, in the group ads channel, there is, well, you should be able to find the server invite in that channel. I mean, 3 million shouldn't be too hard to get with the Alabama. I mean, I never actually used the Alabama, so I don't know 100% how much it makes per hour. But I mean, with fleet income and all that stuff, as long as you have a good grind server, it shouldn't be too difficult, I wouldn't think. Well, the Alabama makes 254,000 credits every hour. I mean, yes, 254,000 every hour. So, without any fleet income, it'll take 4 hours to get 1 million. But of course, there is fleet income, which helps a ton. So, I mean, I feel like it shouldn't be that hard. But also, it is a grinding game, so there's always going to be grinding. I mean, usually, if you want to find a good server where a lot of people are grinding, I mean, usually I just join the biggest server, and I mean, usually there's at least a few aces or LMGs in it. Although, I mean, I will say, yesterday I tried doing that, and it didn't really work that way. There's like no one grinding in the ace. But most of the time, it works like that. Captain Phillips is a good movie. Yeah, I like that movie too. It's called Bad Yacht. I'll put the invite link in the chat. 1 second. Yeah, the movie was actually filmed on an Alabama class, which is pretty cool. Okay, I put a link in chat. I think if that should work, if you just paste it into a browser, I think. Actually, I might have to do another. I might have to send that again. I forgot part of the link. Okay, that link should work. If you just start from the HTTPS part, I accidentally put another, well, yeah, if you, I think if you just click on it, it should work. What's my favorite drink? Honestly, either like fruit punch or lemonade. Fruit punch is goated though. Well, pinball. That is very inspirational right there. Let's see, I actually don't know how much I have right now. 246 and a half million. And if you're verified in Bad Yacht, you should be able to see the channels, theoretically. What do you mean the best route for the G2 oil tanker? Those are two different ships. The best route for oil tanker is Helluva to Ushuaia. The best route for G2 is Wolwyn to Ushuaia. No, I am not a mod in the Bad Yacht Discord server. Best route for Alabama is also Wolin to Ushuaia, and I don't really know how to get unbanned. I mean, you can always appeal, but I think you have to get someone else to appeal for you. Because if you're banned in the server, then you can't really access the appeals. But also, I've never been banned, so I wouldn't really know. Well, I doubt they ignored the appeal, but they might have just denied it. But I don't think they would just straight up ignore it. Okay, if you only see verifying rules, then my guess is you are not completely verified. Here, hold on. Let me see if I can help you. So I think if you need to get verified, you need to like click on the link that it gives you. And then from there, it'll tell you to do like one of two things, I'm pretty sure, if I remember correctly. And it's either like join a game, I think, like on your Roblox account, or like change your Roblox account's description to something that it gives you. And I think if you do one of those two things, then it should verify you. I spend a lot of time on this game. Like, probably way too much. I mean, I play it usually at least once a day, but there'll be times when sometimes I don't play for a few days. Currently, I have 28 days and 10 hours on it. So, I play it a lot. Thank you for subscribing. If it says you're verified but not on the server, I would say probably just keep waiting. I know sometimes it can take a little bit for it to actually like go through. So I guess I would say wait for now. But if it doesn't actually verify you, then I'm not really sure what to do, to be honest. This can go 21.6 knots at level 3. Yeah, it actually is pretty fast, which is really nice. Oh, nice. So if you want to join the Beluga Ace server, there's a channel called Group Ads, And in there, you might have to scroll up a bit, but there's a server called the Beluga Ace Owners Association, and you have to join that. Uh-oh, there's an intruder. The Carpathia is slightly worse than the LNG, but like not by much. I think it makes like 20,000 less an hour than the LNG. So it is worse, but not by much. Scoop, what, you can't say that. You're the one who hosted the event and then left within the first hour. Get back here. Why do I feel like there's gonna be a flying tiki boat soon? Because I hear a tiki boat. And I feel like, well, I saw what happened to King in this video. Now I'm scared. Oh, look at that thing in the sky, a flying tiki boat. UFO, guys. UFO confirmed. Shooting Met is no excuse. Driving big boats is better. Wow, Scoop, you actually came back. This is very surprising. You still have to get to 2 billion. Tiki bar boat flyover. There seems to be an anomaly flying around my boat. This is interesting. Okay, why can I not move my camera? Okay, there. It wasn't letting me move my camera for a second. It was very confusing. I think I just got a brand new haircut. The thing, like, was like a centimeter over my head. Thank you, Lord. I mean, Void. Yay, the ear-deafening rain is coming. That makes me have to mute my game every time it happens. Yeah, the best route is one to Ushuaia. Yeah, the Arctic research ship is pretty cool. I have mine colored to be like like dark gray. And then my side text is Type 45 Destroyer. And it is very nice. To be honest, I don't really know if I should buy the custom decals Game Pass. Because, like, to me, it seems like it's, like, pretty overpriced. And I don't know if I'll really get a ton of usage out of it. Of course, that being said, I did buy the custom, like, the jet ski Game Pass yesterday. Which I know I'll pretty much never get usage out of that. But, I mean, honestly, I put the best, Wait, hold on. Is the can you put decals on with the extra customization game pass, or is that? I'm losing my mind. Hold on. I'm curious now. Oh, I guess you can put decals on with the extra ship customization. For some reason, I thought it was the flag game pass. I guess I never realized I can actually put a decal on, but that's kind of cool. I might have to do that at some point now. Yeah, you can change the side text of it. It's actually pretty cool because it has its own like font and the it has like an outline, like a white outline for the text, so it looks really nice. Speaking of game passes, I feel like something people didn't realize is that they actually added a new credit option, the 5 million credits. This like never used to be here. So Cold Oceanos wasn't actually the person to animate the RAM, so that was Syntax Connoisseur, I'm pretty sure. But yeah, they do look really nice. Yeah, these ramps are really cool. I love them a lot. I mean, the credits definitely aren't cheap, but I think it's kind of good that it's like that. Because, I mean, if they were cheap, then it would be easy for anyone to just buy the credits and then get like the best ship in the game. Which definitely isn't something that I think should be able to happen. So I think it's good that they're expensive. The only time I've ever bought credits was a super long time ago when I first started playing. And I remember I really wanted the Visby Glass Corvette. And it's like 650,000 credits, I think, or 600,000, something around that price. And I spent however many Robux it is to buy. I bought 750,000. I remember that specifically. It was 750,000 credits. Course, that was more expensive back then because they lowered the prices. But out of all the ships, I bought the Visby, which, to be fair, at the time, the Visby I think like the second best, because I think at the time the only ships that actually had PvP were the Ithne. I don't even know if I'm saying that right. The offshore patrol vessel, and then there was the Visby and the OHP. I think the OHP was in the game at the time. It was like a really long time ago. Now I'm gonna go find when I bought those credits because I'm actually curious. Ethna? Alright, thanks. Yes, I bought the Visby from credits. It was, I don't know, it was such a long time ago, and so, like, at the time it was like the second best PvP ship, and like, something about it, I really loved it. And honestly, there is still something about it that I really like. Like, the camo is honestly pretty cool. I remember another thing I liked was the navigation lights and how those are set up. I still really like those navigation lights. I think they're really cool. That's like the only time I've bought credits ever. This is actually, I think, the first time I've ever told anyone that I've bought credits before. And it was years ago. Still trying to find, like, the date that I bought the credits, but I'm kind of struggling. Oh, here it is. It was in 2019. Let's see. Yeah, it was in July of 2019. I bought 600K in like one day, and I think I bought 50K like some other time. Well, I don't think he could have done the entire quest because, I mean, in order to actually start it and like get the Ossa on the Lublin, you have to hit the activate because you can't do it without activating the quest. So he couldn't have really gotten too far. Honestly, I really wish that I played more like during the time of like when I first bought that Visby and stuff. Because I bought the game in 2018, I'm pretty sure, sometime, let me check. But I never really played that much. And I really wish I did because the game was honestly in some ways a lot cooler back then. And I really wish that I had started actually, like, making videos and stuff and, well, just overall playing more because I never got a single screenshot of back then or a single recording. And I just never really played that much, and I really wish I did. Yeah, 2018 DSS was really cool. 2020, I mean, honestly, I doubt I actually played DSS like once in 2020 at all. I really didn't play Roblox in 2020, to be honest. But even though I didn't play in 2018, I know for a fact it was a really cool time to be around. But I didn't really actually get into the game until like late 2021. I remember when I so cuz I played when the old map was still around back in 2018 and stuff. And I remember when I first got back because I had last played when the old map was still a thing, and then I got back in 2021 when the new map was out. And I remember that Tamar, is it Tamar or Tamar? I don't know. I'm gonna say Tamar. The Tamar class lifeboat. Because you could only spawn it at that one lifeboat station. And I remember I could have sworn there was one at Wolin, but I could never find it. And I spent like such a long time looking for the lifeboat station at Wolin, and I never found it. Because I had no. I was just like, where did it go? And then. Actually, only a few days ago did I finally realize that there was actually a lifeboat station on Wolin. I found a photo of it with old Wolin in the background, with, the bridge and everything. And I don't know. It was just kind of funny because I remember I searched for that LiFO station for such a long time when I first got back, and I was like, "Where the hell did it go?" Because I could have sworn it was there, and then I just thought that I must have been going crazy or something. And then, like, less than a week ago, I actually found proof that there was in fact a LiFO station at Wolin, and that was kind of funny. Dude, Old Wolin, I have no memory of it whatsoever, but I miss it so well. I mean, I don't know if I can say that I miss it, but I kind of wish it was back. Because one, I think that LiFO station at Wolin would have been really nice, but also that bridge was so cool. And obviously they had to remove it because with the G2 problem and everything, and especially with the ships now, they're just too tall. But that bridge at night with the neon lights and everything, that bridge was so pretty. I'd like pray that they bring something like that back in Nautica. Because that neon light bridge looks so pretty at night. Like, I'm like really sad that they removed it, but obviously they had to. Don't know, maybe they should just add back neon lights to that little drawbridge in Wolin. Yeah, I mean, I understand it was inaccurate and stuff, but I just, it would have been so nice to still have some of those things. And I mean, we don't know about the islands coming in Nautica, and I don't know if they're based off of IRL islands. I kind of doubt it. Actually, I'm willing to bet they're probably fictional islands, but I mean, which I kind of like that though, because it gives them a lot more freedom to actually do cool things. Like that neon bridge or whatever, or other things, of course. But honestly, I'm obsessed with that neon bridge. Like, I just hope that there's something like that in Nautica. Even though it's probably pretty unlikely. Those map leaks you're talking about are. Oh my god, the rain. Go away. I imagine the map leaks you're talking about are for Ascension Island, which was a planned island for DSS3, but never got added. But there are some teasers in it, or teasers for it, which are pretty cool to look at, but they never. I mean. It could still come back in Nautica, but I doubt it, because like I said, I imagine the islands are probably going to be fictional. But also, I kind of doubt that they would tease the map, especially years ago, because I mean, when those teasers came out, I honestly don't even think Nautica was being worked on. Yeah, I also think the waves will be really cool. A huge new map? What's. I've been through that entire teasers channel multiple times and I've never seen. Oh, that those map concepts. Yeah, those were for. No, I know what you're talking about now. Yeah, I've seen a few of those different map concepts. Those were for DSS3 though. I'm like 99% sure. No, you will not keep the game passes and stats from DSS3 and Nautica. It's a completely different game. It's not even a part of the Dynamic Ship Simulator series. So you will not keep those stats or game passes. Honestly, I'm really curious to see what happens with DSS3 once Nautica comes out. Because obviously, I mean, the developers have said that it'll stay open. So, I mean, that's nice. But I feel like Nautica will kind of, I mean, honestly, probably kill DSS3. Because Nautica is going to be most likely so much better. I mean, I have no doubt it'll be so much better. And so, and I mean, all the players that play DSS3, I'm sure they're like 99% of them are gonna go to Nautica. So I'm like, is DSS3 just gonna kind of die out? Like, I don't know. And I mean, it's such a good game as it is. So it'll be kind of sad if it does die out, but I mean, honestly, I think it's kind of inevitable. See, the funny thing is, Opapile is probably going to get beta access to Nautica since, you know, richest person in DSS3, which means that he's gonna get an early start. So he'll probably, again, as long as he, you know, keeps up the same amount of dedication as he does with DSS3, then he'll probably still remain one of the richest people because he'll have that early start as well as just overall being a dedicated player. How much money do I have? I think I made 2 million so far. And silver, I cannot make anything on stream. Making a boat on stream would go horrible. I suck at it so much. And I know I have to like learn and stuff, but I can't imagine that going well. But also there's the whole problem with if I open my file explorer, my full name is on display in some spots, so I can't exactly do that. Honestly, it seems like everyone's making a boat or a ship. I mean, like, so many people are making them now, which is kind of cool. I really like looking at, like, the development, like, the different stages of people making boats. Transitions are a thing. That's complicated, though. I mean, not really, but I'd rather not have to do a transition or switch to another screen every 10 seconds when I want to insert something. Although, to be fair, I mean, as long as I have it on my like file explorer or whatever on my second monitor and I just drag stuff in, I think theoretically that'd just be fine. But still, I kind of don't want to risk showing my entire name. Why do I have all D's in chat? No. Look, honestly, Blender, if I tried to do it, like, I think I would actually lose my mind. I think I have, like, a grand total of, like, 2.5 hours on Blender, and most of that time is just for me having it open in the background while watching tutorials. And honestly, like, I don't know if I could handle it. Blender makes me lose my sanity. Yeah, so Scoop, I see those map concepts you pinged me in. Those were almost certainly for DSS3, if I had to imagine. Because that was at the time where they were trying to figure out like what they actually wanted to do with the map. And also, I'm like 99% sure Nautica wasn't even being made of, I mean, made when those teasers were released. But they are still very interesting to look at. I mean, you can see Portsea Islands on one of them, which was a planned island, but again, never got added. I have three different map concepts saved on my computer, like the three main ones, I think. Honestly, Silver, I don't know if I can handle a stream, a Blender stream. I'm trying to open one of the photos right now, but literally it's just not opening. I have the blue spinning wheel of death on my cursor, which I find is kind of interesting. I didn't know it takes this much processing power to open a photo. Oh wow, it's not. Error. Wow. That's sad. Oh, yep, again. Thank you. Four times now. Okay. Are we good now? No, we're not good now. Silver, he had to leave you. He had to go participate in his own grind event that he left within the first hour of him hosting it. Scoop, if you submit a ship for shipping lanes and it gets in, I'm never forgiving you. Gosh, how hard is it to open a photo? You just bought the G2, nice. I'm trying to open these map concepts so I can show them on stream because they're kind of cool, but literally, it will not let me. I don't understand. Minecraft stream, but Blender stream. This is a DSS3 channel though. So like, I don't really do stuff that's not DSS3. Why can we not go 10 minutes without the deafening rain? Yeah, Scoop, stop spamming. Jeez. Face reveal at 1K? I don't think you guys want to see that though. Like, honestly. Mildly, welcome to the stream. So I finally figured out a way to actually open the photos, although it's in like the Snip and Sketch app, so it's not exactly ideal. But I did find here. Let me show it. I think this will work. Maybe. Nope, didn't work. Okay, hold on. There we go. This is the most interesting map concept to me, mostly because I have no clue what this red area, like, I forgot I can actually circle it. Okay, hold on, that's kind of thick. But like, I have no clue what this area down here is supposed to be, which like is interesting to me. And I mean, you have most of the other places, of course, Portsea Island, and then you have Witty, which was a new one. But it's pretty interesting to look at. Silver, I think you could maybe just join and do that yourself. I'm not exactly a telephone. And yeah, Scoop, it does look actually pretty similar. Like, Woolen and Hobbleline are in, I mean, Hobbleline's a little lower than it used to be, or than it is right now. You have Ushuaia, I'm pretty sure it's actually Ushuaia, I think. And I've been saying it Ushuaia this entire time, but yeah. You have Ushuaia at the top, which is the same spot. But I mean, really, I think the thing that's most interesting to me is that red area. And I think Bornholm and Tenerife are the same. I mean, they're flipped now on the current map, but I think that's how they used to be on the old map, if I'm not mistaken. Or maybe I am completely mistaken. Okay, hold on, now I have to find the old map because now I'm curious. great. I messed up the opening of the photo, so now there's gonna be another Windows error sound. You think it's Ushuaia? Maybe. I don't think it's Ushuaia. I feel like the way it's pronounced is Ushuaia. I think a dev said that's how you say it, like, a while ago. So, I think that's how you say it. Okay, I was totally wrong about Tenerife and Bornholm being, like, where I thought that they were on the old map. Okay, fine. I will say hi to Birdie. How's this message? This beautiful message right here. If I don't get any feedback from Silver, I'm just gonna send it. I mean, you could just like message him on Discord or something. I think he has Discord. I think I've seen him like a few times. Okay, I will send that. Okay, there you go. I sense it. Now we wait. Oh, I misspent one of the words. Okay. You see that message from Ofa? Okay, the communication has succeeded. Let me know what you want me to say. Alright, I'll tell him that. So Scoop, speaking on the topic of those old map concepts, I do have this other map concept saved, and it's from, it was like an extension to that really big one you sent me. And so that top right island right here, this is Ascension Island, the one that was planned to be added, and actually had a decent amount of progress done on it. Oh, I shouldn't share that. Hold on. I did not mean to share that part. Okay. But the map concept is really cool to look at. There's actually some photos that got released of it and stuff, and it's really cool. So like, if you look at it here, you have this like this was the runway that was planned for it, the long airstrip. So like there's part of it, and then there's also gonna be a lifeboat station, which was really cool. I have a few photos of that. I actually have a lot of photos of the lifeboat station, but it would take too long to open them all. But I mean, it's kind of cool to see that there was going to be that. And then, yeah, you sent that one map concept in my Discord server that I see for Ascension Island. I just realized I was muted the entire time. That's fun. Anyways, I was gonna say, I think it's cool. On the left, you can actually see Ascension Island because it kind of says, like, it shows how far along it got. Apparently, it was like 50% complete, but it had like too many triangles or whatever, so it never got finished. Ignore my dog in the background, jeez. My dogs get very loud sometimes. I would think that possessed would be the right word. Silver, stop. I mean, not Silver, Scoop, stop exposing everything I'm gonna cover in my DSS3 Iceberg Part 3 in general. But not really, you're fine. Yeah, I know you're just looking through teasers. It's just kind of funny because a lot of the stuff in my next Iceberg video is from teasers, or at least some of the photos are. I'll make a Nautica iceberg once Nautica gets released. I think that sort of has to come first, you know? Oh yeah, I forgot the volcano's audio was also bugged. So it happens like multiple times. All right, I think I'm gonna end the stream once I finish this ace run. once I drop off this, all these cars, I'm going to end the stream. Thank you guys so much for coming to the stream. And I'll see you guys all later. Bye.